but how quickly she could beat home. Here's a quote from Nancy Armour from the USA Today. Rousey fell victim to the same trap, caught up in her own hype. She took the over-the-top arrogance to the extreme, demeaning her opponents, manufacturing vendettas, threatening to beat up Kim Kardashian or anyone else who annoyed her. Rousey captured the sporting world's attention with her bad girl, I can beat Floyd Mayweather, greatest female fighter ever attitude. But now that we look back, did that attitude actually hurt her in the end?
I think we got to back it all the way up to how she got to where she was. And part of that is because she's playing by a different set of rules as a female athlete. She can't just be good at her sport. She has to also manufacture headlines. She has to, every time she approaches a fork in the road and can take the more explosive, confrontational route, or she could take the good girl, say the right thing route, she kind of had to take the explosive route because she needed to get attention. She needed to build a platform, and I thought she was really smart about how she did that. I mean, she won a medal, an Olympic medal in judo. We didn't know who she was. Obviously, moving into a sport where it's also validating this type of confrontational behavior was helpful to her. I don't think she would have been saying the same things if she was in a basketball or a tennis. A lot of it was the climate of what MMA and UFC brings. But, so my point is that if she was a male athlete, she could just say whatever she wanted, whether that was explosive or not, and being good at her sport would have gotten the headlines. She couldn't do that. She had to make the headlines. So in a lot of ways, we saw her manufacturing these interactions with Floyd Mayweather, with the Kardashians, with almost everything, with Bieber, too. She had to do that. Now, I do think that once she built her platform, she kind of kept her foot on the gas there. And I don't know if that was habitual. I don't know if she kind of got into a rhythm of like, I'm always taking that one road. I'm always taking that one road. She already had the 1.7 million Twitter followers. Everybody was tuning into her matches. I don't know that she needed to go the extra mile with Holly, but I do know that that is how she built her platform. And so I completely understand that that was habitual for her.
You know, the conversation after this fight largely revolves around why has there been such a glee in Ronda Rousey's loss? Why have people been so ready to jump on this and say, see, she wasn't everything she was built up to be? You point out, well, she needed to take this road to draw attention to herself, that she needed to hype things up in order to achieve this status in the athletic world. But then the lesson should be clear. If your goal is look at me, if your goal is attention, be prepared for the kind of attention you are going to receive. It will come with the positive, and it will come with the negative. And what Ronda Rousey is experiencing this week, what people are saying this week, is a direct result of the look at me she performed for weeks. Now, I think it's interesting the words that you used, that Nancy Armour used. You said she had to manufacture headlines with the Kardashians. Armour said that she was caught up in her own hype. Here is why people are responding so gleefully to her loss, because they don't like being sold a lie. And Ronda Rousey's excellence, or not, that's not fair. Ronda Rousey was excellent. Ronda Rousey as the world's greatest female athlete, Ronda Rousey as somebody who could beat Floyd Mayweather, was a lie. And so when people hear that over and over, I think they have a natural reaction to that, a natural negative reaction to that. They gravitate, I think, perhaps naively and hope, that they gravitate towards the truth. And Ronda Rousey, and not just her fault, by the way, external forces made up the lie. Dana White, for the sake of his organization, for the sake of his sport, built her up bigger than she was. The idea that she could beat Floyd Mayweather was absurd. And she played that up, that she could take Floyd Mayweather. And people wanted to believe that for a variety of reasons, including the fact it would be really awesome if a female athlete could whip a male athlete, especially one that has domestic violence issues, right? Who, by the way, hypes his own stuff beyond reality as well. That would be such a sweet little modern story of justice. But the problem is, it wasn't true. Ronda Rousey was great. She was not the greatest female athlete of our time. She wasn't the greatest female athlete on the face of the earth. That's a huge insult to people like Serena Williams. She wasn't even, as it turns out, the best female MMA fighter. Todd said earlier in the tease, you know, she was the baddest woman on the planet. No, she's not the baddest woman on the planet. Holly Holm has very right claim to that right now today.
I don't think we can call it a lie yet.
Was it true or not true?
Certainly a dent has been put into this mystique. I don't think anybody was ever saying that she was never going to get beat. I think we like the spectacle of watching it, and I think we will like the spectacle of watching the rematch between Holly and Rousey. I don't think it's an out-and-out lie to say that she was one of the greatest female athletes, or it, I don't know why I'm using past tense, is one of the greatest female athletes. A lot of great athletes take losses.
But the lie is, you have to admit, Kate, the lie is how highly it was built up. It was sold to us. She participated in this. Could she have ever beaten Floyd Mayweather, honestly? Was that ever going to happen?
If she can beat Floyd Mayweather?
Yes.
No, of course I don't. And I'm also not a proponent who thinks like women can play in the WNBA. But the reason she said she could, and this gets back to my original point, is that spotlights exist on male athletes. So when Brittany Griner, when Mark Cuban said Brittany Griner could play in the NBA, that's because the spotlight is on the NBA. So of course they're going to entertain that because they want to jump into that spotlight. The same thing was happening with Rousey there. When people were putting spotlights on certain things, she wanted to be a part of those conversations to build up this brand. Now, do I think that, I think there was a little bit lacking in terms of the depth of quality of MMA fighters that we weren't talking about enough. And certainly the progression in its evolution of women's MMA. It's kind of like, well, 50 years from now, I'm assuming there will be a wealth more of MMA fighters, and Ronda Rousey will be seen more as like a pioneer who played and fought at a time where the depth wasn't there. But that doesn't, all she can do is fight in the moment she's in. So I don't think that completely distracts her. I think it's a little much to say she's a lie at this point. Certainly.
Well, it wasn't true.
Well, what wasn't true exactly? That she could beat any human anywhere ever? If you really believed that and didn't see that that was part of a UFC MMA hype, well, then you're kind of responsible, too, you know, for buying into that and being a little gullible.
I think a decent parallel for Ronda Rousey right now is Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson, for years, was sold as the baddest man on the planet, one of the greatest boxers of all time, perhaps the greatest boxer of all time. And I don't know if you've seen the latest 30 for 30 on Chasing Tyson. But right there, under his nose the entire time, was Evander Holyfield. The truth was, Evander Holyfield was the best fighter on the planet during that entire time. And Mike Tyson was way overhyped. Ronda Rousey, fairly similar.
The question that we have on the screen is, was she too arrogant? And if you watch the fight itself, she didn't realize that she was getting beat. She had in her mind, I should be able to dominate this girl. Tactics be damned. She was way too aggressive. She should have gone to her bread and butter and tried to take her down more. Instead, she wanted to prove to the world that she was indeed as bad as she'd been saying, instead of having a smart fight and winning the way she knows she could have won. So perhaps in the rematch, she'll do it that way. But I think she got too caught up in the hype when she was actually in the fight itself, and it cost her the loss.
Could be.
I believe she believed that hype.
Yes, she believed it. The Cowboys are expected to finally have Tony Romo back this weekend. Can he save their season? Where's the halo and wings?
Will's Cowboys season.
Oh. And the Texans.
Miracle.
The Texans,
too,
you said?
And a miracle.
He's a polygamist.
Not the Texans.
Why are you so Texas-centric?
Why?
Where I'm from.
Yeah, but you can't support another team from another state?
There's a strict rules on that, Todd. We can go over what those rules are, but there are very strict rules on when you
live
in
New York now, so you're...